The three gears of the economy of the United States. Now, if you can imagine that the United States of America has three gears in it, similar to the idea of an old wind-up watch that had gears in it, similar to any machine that operates on gears. So there are three gears, okay? The gear of the corporation, the gear of the war cycle, and the gear of the Constitution. So you will see it in front of you, and I put in the center the war cycle. Now that was my first video that I ever made, called the 80-year war cycle. And the original first video that I made is on War Backwards is Raw. And if you go to that channel, just go to the very first video, the oldest video. When I made the video, I basically had almost no attention on the video. It's very simple. But as time went on, it began to pick up. And the truth of that video is even more apparent right now in the year 2021. So at the center of the economy is the war cycle. Now I've identified it as an 80-year war cycle, and that's the heart of it. And I know there are other wars that don't fit into the 80-year war cycle, and I'll try my best to try to associate those other wars in this complex gear mechanism of the economy. So if we begin in the year 1781, that's when Americans or the colonists were hoaxed with the fake American Revolutionary War. And it will end in 1781, but the peace treaty will not be signed until a few years later. But we're going to use the year 1781. So the next war will occur in 1861. 1781 plus 80 is 1861. Fake Civil War. All right, let's go another 80 years. 1861, 80 years plus, 1941, fake World War II. Let's go another 80 years. Brings us to the present moment. This video is being produced in November of 2021, and we are in the midst of another war, a different type of war. And when I made videos on the 80-year war cycle, I had a prediction that the year 2021 would see a major war. But the type of war that's being waged is not like the wars of the past, whereby the wars in the past, people put on uniforms. In a way, they do right now. They put on uniforms. And they used guns to shoot bullets. Shots were fired. Even right now, shots are fired. Okay? So in the year 2021, the 80-year war cycle came true. Now, why do they conduct fake wars? Well, there are lots of reasons, but of course, primarily, those who are in on the fake wars make fortunes. Fortunes are made by waging war. But as far as we are concerned, that is the public or the common people, the wars create debt. Huge debt. Debt beyond your comprehension. Debt beyond anything I can ever fathom in my thinking. So, in a way, the fake wars are like the body with the deeds, the action. Okay? So at the center I have the fake wars. That's kind of your central gear with the three gears. Now, in order to function effectively, there needs to be a body. And that's where I look to the corporation. And the definition of a corporation is a corpse with an oration. Something that's actually dead, not living, but it has an oration, it has a mouth. That's kind of the literal definition of a corporation. Okay, so prior 1871 is the big year for the start of America becoming a corpse with an oration. That is when America will go from basically being a colony or a subsidiary of England. Okay. All the stuff about George Washington and breaking free of England was phony. The United States, otherwise known as America, has always been under the control of England. And even as I speak, it still is under the control of England. Think about it. Why would King George let go of a vast amount of real estate? Some think the word real estate is kind of a corruption of royal estate. So America would be his royal estate. Now, so after 1871, America is no longer a colony. It's a corpse with an oration. Now, people ask me on this 80-year war cycle thing, how do the other wars tie in? And I have to admit, I don't have all the answers. But if you take the 80-year war cycle, and then you take the 80-year corporation cycle, and you take 1871 and add 80, you get 1951. Well, guess what America was doing in 1951? Korea. That's right. So the United States is and functions as a corporation. So that's another gear in the three-gear system. So back to the main focal point of the board. Again, you have your three gears. The center gear is the fake wars. And then the gear on my left as I speak would be the corporation, or the body with the oration. So that brings us to the third gear, which is the Constitution. Okay, now when America supposedly got free, it was covered under what was called the Articles of Confederation. And then the hoax liars, Masons, came up with a Constitution. And that was pushed and passed. And so in a way, that took away from the independence of the particular states in the United States, the sovereignty of the states, now coming under one body, sort of forming that one body. And remember, the New World Order people are all about oneness. They want one body. They want one religion. And they want one government. So one world economy, one world religion, one world government. So the Constitution, as it occurred in 1793. Now I call that con number one, because what they will do in the formulation of these constitutions, they will change the title slightly. And if you change one letter, it's an entirely different constitution. So the first con, it is the Constitution for the United States of America. Now remember, the Constitution is a mouthpiece, okay? You might say that's the mouth of the body, of the corpus of the oration, right? So that will speak for the corporation. And that's why in America, the two most important positions are president of the corporation, secretary of the corporation. All right, so con number two comes in 1863. It's the Constitution of the United States of America. Now remember, this is a 70-year cycle. So you got to go from 1863 to 1933. And remember, if you've watched some of my other videos, 1933 is very important, because on March the 9th, 1933, that would be the third month, and the third three, or the ninth of the third month of 33, everything collapses. And anything and everything that you ever thought you knew about a valid government is gone. Gone, gone, gone. Because you've been conned. All right, now, this Constitution, con number three, I believe the subtlety is it's of United States, not of America. So the previous constitutions were of America. So they switched it. So anytime anybody talks about the Constitution of the United States, don't pay too much attention. Don't hold the Constitution like the Bible or some sacred religious book. It's not. It's a con. I know there are so many people out there that they're truthers and they love videos like what I make or others make, and they want to uphold the Constitution. But it's just a con, and it's another aspect of the entire system of fooling people. So again, in the year 2003, you have the Constitution appearing in all caps. So again, back to the idea of the variation of even one letter that creates an entire new document. One letter, even just capitalizing one letter, even missing a little thing like of or for, substituting of for for, creates an entire new document. So if what I'm saying is true, then the next con coming is 2073. Now why is the Constitution so important? Because the Constitution is the mouth. And the mouth will speak and say, the debt goes upon all the corpses with orations. Now, do you know who that is? That's the man or the woman on your driver's license in capital letters. That's the man or woman on your deed to your home that you think you own, which you really don't. That's the man or woman on the certificate of title for your car, and you think that it now belongs to you. No, it belongs to your corpse with the oration. And all corpses with orations are responsible for what? Guess what? The center gear. Okay? The fake wars and the debts that they create. So try to take it back to the overall picture of everything. And the overall picture of everything is this. There's three gears in the economy. The central gear that I identify is the fake wars. Okay, that would be at the center. Now they create debt. And where does that debt go? Well, it goes what the mouthpiece says, or the Constitution. Okay? Now how do they get away with just, you know, bebopping around and creating all these fake wars? Because it's a corporation. It's a body. The United States is a body. It's not really what you think it is. And incidentally, that explains why all wars after World War II are what they call undeclared wars. In other words, the Constitution, the way the government was set up, was that the Congress had to, quote, declare war for there to be an actual war. And what happened was that, basically speaking, in 1933, you got the whole United States was just completely demolished. And so what you have now is just a phony government, and that's all it is, Congress, Senate, with actors, and that's basically what most of them are. Some of them are famous people with disguises. Some of them are people that are just wealthy and like to go out and dress up and pretend like it's Halloween, and they play the role of a senator, congressman, congresswoman, because there's no need for a government, because all government was abolished in 1933. And you know, you've got these folks that yell and scream about, oh, they're going to declare martial law. Well, listen, I want to tell you something. Martial law has been in effect since 1933. That's why you can see them do anything they want and bypass anything in the fake government. Because it's military rule. It's been military rule since 1933. Now, I know that flies over the head of many, many people, because they want to believe in, guess what? The Constitution. But the Constitution was a con. Just as everything that's done in the hoax lie system is a con. So where does this leave you? Where does this leave me? Well, it leaves us in a system where we basically feel pretty helpless, but not hopeless. What do I mean by that? Well, as a believer in the Lord Jesus, I don't belong in this world. Now, I live in this world. I drive a car in this world. I go to the grocery store in this world and buy groceries. And my corpse with oration pays taxes. My corpse with oration gets stopped by the state trooper for speeding or for not pulling into the passing lane when he's sitting on the right-hand side of the road with his flashing lights on and there's no one around. Yes, that happened to me. That happened to my corpse with the oration. So yes, I mean, I'm not trying to sound idiotic to you. I live in this world, but I'm not of it. And I'm of the kingdom of God, which means this entire turf is the turf of the devil. But I don't live under the power of the devil. I live under the power and the rule of the Lord Jesus. So I hope that's a little word of hope after presenting all this to you. Now, I know what it can do to many folks is they will shut down. They won't want this type of information because it can overwhelm you. But as Jesus said, be of good cheer, for I have overcome the world. So I don't care how much this fake, phony world throws at me. I don't care how much is thrown at me. I don't belong to it. I belong to a kingdom that cannot be shaken. And I don't want you to be shaken by this information or by any of the falsehoods of the hoax liars who try to control us. Because the day will come when this world will be gone and the eternal kingdom of Jesus the Christ will be established forever. So once again, my friend, I would like to thank you for watching this video, and I would like to say I tried my best to present something to you, and it could have some flaws in it. It could have some errors in it, I admit. But what I want you to see is the big picture of the three gears in the economy of the United States. Now, if you're from another country and you're listening to this video, you might be able to do exactly as I have done for your country or your nation. And I'm sorry, I'm not familiar with history of other nations and everything like that. I just struggle enough to try to piece this together here in the United States or in America. But if you're from another country, try to look for basically the same things that I have shown you here. Fake wars, a corporation that rules your country, and then some mouthpiece or some constitution that puts the debt on the people and the inhabitants of the nation where you live. Thank you for watching this video. End of video.